Hi, horse people. Well, someone asked me to if I thought this horse was big enough for this person. And this is a I think they call it a Ford. I think the J's silent. But I've heard it pronounced Forge. Anyway, however you pronounce the horse, let's take a look at this and see if okay, normally when a horse is in pain or is hurting, she's pretty far back because she's wide. She's way back here. This is where a horse's kidneys are. So, I mean, it looks like she's got a pretty good saddle and it's distributing her weight, but she's not what I call an easy load. I talk about being an easy load. If you ride like a sack of potatoes, you're a hard load. If you're 100 pounds, and you ride like a sack of potatoes, it's like the horse carrying 200 pounds. But you can be 200 pounds and carry yourself well using your ankles, knees, hips, all that to balance your weight and minimize your bouncing. You will be a lighter load. So it all depends on how well. She seems to be just sitting there from what I ride. When a horse carries their tail up like that, that can be an indicator of pain or discomfort. The ears are another pain and discomfort. Of course, she has a bit with a long, long shank. This is very common with people that can't ride because it creates so much pain. The horse is very scared to move or do anything. You'll notice she keeps kicking this horse to go, but these reins are pretty tight. So the horse is in pain not to run, but she's kicking him to run. So we have poor riding, mixed signals, but Rick, she's got a helmet on, so she's safe. Okay. So walking a horse is much better than a trot. A trot, you really need to know how to ride to minimize your weight. A trot is the hardest thing on a horse's back. You don't want to trot a horse a lot. That's not good. Either a canter to where they're in a full gallop to where you can move with them, or a walk is better than a trot. Now, people are going to say, well, Rick, if you know how to post, a trot isn't bad. Yeah, I get it. Most people don't know how to post, and most people don't understand the concept of minimizing your weight and bouncing and using your hips, knees, and ankles as shock absorbers so the horse doesn't have to take all that up and down shocking.
Trying to slow his trot down.
Notice the tight reins. She's pulling on the reins every step and she doesn't know it. Yet she keeps kicking on a horse. But this long leverage shank bit creates so much torque. And this is a gag bit, what I call a gag bit, because it's hooked directly to the headstall. So as she pulls up, it makes this get tighter because it pulls down on the headstall and it pulls back on the bit. So we create pressure on behind the pole and up in the horse's jaw as you're pulling. And then you have these long shanks, which, you know, maximize the pull. If you're pulling 1 pound of pressure with long shanks like this, you maybe get 10 pounds of pressure for every 1 pound you pull. So when you're bouncing and your hands going back and forth, you're creating 2-3 pounds of pressure. The horse is feeling 30-40 pounds of pressure. His tail is active. His butt's honked in, his ears aren't comfortable, and he's getting a gag bit. And you wonder why the horse doesn't want to walk. See this tail up? To me, this is too much weight on a horse. In my opinion, this woman's too big for this horse. This horse is in pain when she's riding him. It compounds the pain because of her lack of ability. Do you think she could stand up on her toes right now? I don't think so. Not to mention she's wearing clogs or flops or something with no heel, which means her heel can slip through the reins and get dragged. Let me get this. I had this little low so you can see her head. Although the cameraman's not keeping on her head. This horse, see her kicking? constantly kicking and kicking, but yet constantly pulling and pulling on the bit. But Rick, she has a helmet on. Okay, I know that means she's good, smart, she's equestrian. I know.
No, don't go around me.
Kick, kick, kick. Riding with no heel shoes, bad. I mean, this is just a disaster on multiple levels. Notice these reins go loose and tight, loose and tight. This is what I talk about, rein control. This is what I talk about, riders that don't have a clue. She's looking ahead. She doesn't have a clue about how she's bouncing. She doesn't have a clue that the horse is in pain from the tail. And she doesn't have a clue that she's always in the horse's mouth, giving mixed signals. Kicking and pulling. Kicking and pulling. Kicking and pulling. Bouncing. Kicking. Pulling. See that tail? To me, that indicates pain. That horse is uncomfortable. That's just comfort. Who thinks this is fun for the horse or the rider? But evidently the rider's having fun. I don't know. She's got a helmet on. She's got a saddle. Probably got a bunch of pink ribbons that she won as a kid. Probably an instructor in giving riding lessons. Active tail. Okay. You wanted my opinion? This horse is in pain, and this woman's too big for this horse. That's my opinion. All right, we'll end that there, poor little horse. Looks like a good little horse.